Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. So today let's see how we can detect faces in images and videos using OpenCV and Python. So let's put 2 minutes on the clock and get started. First of all, you need to install OpenCV and you can do it using pip. Today we'll be using Haar Cascades for detecting faces, and this is a machine learning based approach where a cascade function is trained with a set of input data. And OpenCV already contains many pre-trained classifiers for face, eyes, smiles, etc. So you can use these, and today we'll be using the face classifier, and you can experiment with other classifiers as well. So let's download the train classifier file. We'll be using this one, the frontal face default. Simply open it and click on raw right here. So now you have the raw file. Now you simply you can right click and save as, and you can save this file and move it to the directory where you are working. Okay, so we have the cascade here. So first, obviously you have to import OpenCV, so import CV2. Next, let's load the classifier. So today I'll be testing this on this image that I have. So let's load that as well. Now one thing you have to remember is that this method works only on grayscale images. So we need to convert our RGB image to grayscale. An interesting thing to note is that CV2 processes images in BGR, that is blue, green and red, instead of the usual RGB. So it's nothing different, just the colors, the order of the colors are different, that's all. Now let's try and detect the faces. So let's say face is equal to. So this function takes three arguments. One is the image itself, the grayscale image. Next is the scale factor, let be 1.1. And next is the minimum neighbors, so let it be 4. So I've left a link in description where these two parameters are explained in detail, and you can read about this more there. You'll mostly have to play around with these values and see which values work best for you. Okay, I found that these two values work best for my image. And the detected faces are returned as coordinates of a rectangle. So for each face that was detected, we are going to draw a rectangle around it so that we can see it clearly. So faces will be a list of coordinates. So I can write for x, y, w, and h in faces, and I'll draw a rectangle over my image. So this means that the rectangle color will be blue, right? B, G, and R, and this would be the thickness of the rectangle. Now to see the image, so this will wait for a key press to close the image. Okay, so let's try and run this code. Okay, my spelling is wrong. Okay, let's try again. So you can see that it's detected all the five faces perfectly. Now similarly, we can detect faces in videos as well. So we know a video is made up of frames, right? So which are actually still images. So we perform this detection on each frame in a video, right? So to do that, we need to make some slight modifications to the code. So instead of images, we'll be reading frames from the video, right? So let's create a video capture object. So this zero tells it to capture the video from my webcam, okay? And if you want to detect the faces in a video file, then you could simply put your file name in here. So I'll be using the webcam today. Now let's run an infinite loop. Let's get each frame from the video. So what cap.read does is that it returns two variables. The first one is a flag that is used to indicate whether the frame was read correctly or not, and the second variable, that's the frame itself. Okay, I'm calling that image. So this is the frame, and everything else is essentially the same. I convert it into grayscale and I detect the faces inside that image. and I draw the rectangle, and same I show the image, right? And since this is an infinite loop, we need some way to break off from this loop, right? So let's say k. Now this simply tells it to break the loop if the escape key is pressed, okay? And finally, let's release the video capture object. So let's try and run this. Hey there. So you can see that this is detecting my face pretty accurately, even if I move around, right? And like I said, you can play with these parameters until you are satisfied with the detection. And yeah, so to close this, press escape. So that's it for today, guys. I'll put all the code on GitHub, and if you prefer the written version of this tutorial, then you can also check out my Medium post. I'll put the links in the description. So thank you so much for watching, and if you found this video useful, please do like and share it, and also subscribe to my channel for more such videos, and I'll see you in the next one.